What's up, people? Happy Monday. The beginning of the week. I hate the beginning of the week because it seems like Friday is so long away. Today's episode, very good. I just got a couple things to say. Elizabeth, I'm going to start with this skank. You know, everybody know, if you watch my reviews over the past couple years, you know my feelings on Elizabeth. And you know, I would love the day when the writers either write her out of town or just kill this bitch off. I know everybody on this show does their dirt and everybody does, you know, despicable things, but she is low. She is the lowest of the fucking low. If there weren't children involved in this kind of storyline, I would be probably all up into it. I wouldn't really judge her. I wouldn't really anything. Like, I would just wait for the fallout. But there's kids involved. Not just her children, but Sam's kid. You got her son involved in this too because you're keeping his father away from him. So it's okay for Jake to sit there and bond with a son that he doesn't really know is his son and two other children that are not his. It's okay because those are her kids, but you're keeping him away from his legal wife and his son with said wife. That's where I draw the fucking line. I even draw the line when it comes to her kids because they don't, you know, Jake doesn't even know that that's really his father. So, and what was sad today, what was so sad was the fact that Jake came downstairs because he said he had a bad dream that Big Jake, you know, Jason was going to leave like all his other dads. I said, that's a damn shame. He said all his dads. That is a damn shame for a kid to even say something like that. You got a, 10-year-old boy talking about all his dads. No little kid should say he got more than one father. That makes you look like a straight up thought bot. I'm just saying, like, you're a thotty. Like, for real, you're a straight up slur. Like, it makes no sense. Elizabeth, you got all these kids by different fathers. You've had a couple miscarriages. Had she never lost Rick, baby, the bitch would have four kids by four different dudes. Like, seriously, that says a lot about you, woman. I just have no feelings towards Elizabeth whatsoever but hatred. I just can't stand that character. Like, she's... Because the reason I don't like her was because she's so hypocritical about Carly. I remember over the years, she hated Carly. She said so many nasty things about Carly. But bitch, you're worse than Carly. And that's saying something because Carly done some shit in her life. But you're worse. Come on now. You're the worst. You changed somebody's DNA results to make it look like their child died. The person who you claim to love. You made it seem so that his son was really dead. All because you wanted him for yourself. And she knows she could be Jason. She says Jason is the love of her life. Jason may be the love of your life, but you're not the love of his life. And she know that. And she's jealous and she's angry about it. That's why she has to resort to such. She has to, you know, resort to such tactics. She has to go through these shenanigans just to keep him in her orbit because she knows she's not the love of his life. He may be the love of your life, but you're not the love of his. And that's what you're mad about. Sam is the love of his life. Out of all the women Jason done been with, the only bitch that he chose outright was Sam. The only woman he chose outright. Mind you, every time he had a choice to make between Sam and Elizabeth, who did he always choose? Sam. He never chose Elizabeth. The only reason he ever been with Elizabeth was due to circumstances. That's the only reason he ever been with this bitch. I remember when they got engaged in 2008. That engagement lasted all of 2 seconds. But who got the title of Mrs. Morgan? Sam. Elizabeth never held that title. And bitch, guess what? She would never hold the title of Mrs. Morgan. I'm sure of that. I don't give a fuck what writer comes along. She ain't never gonna marry Jason. We all know it. She's never gonna. The bitch ain't never even come close. I know some people gonna say, well, they were engaged at one point. That engagement lasted, like I said, 2 seconds. After Michael got shot, it was over. Just like that. You blink, you missed it. That's how that engagement went. You blink, you missed it. I'm just ready for her to go. Now all of a sudden she want to grow a conscience and try to tell him the truth, but yet you already know she's not gonna tell him the truth because she's a selfish bitch. Moving on. Sam, she's caught in between a rock and a hard place because her father, everybody accusing him of shooting Sonny. I don't think he did it, honestly. I'm just going to be honest about it. I don't know who did it. I don't think it was Julian because it would be too obvious for it to be Julian, so I don't believe that. The PCPD, they might have Julian in lockup, but the PCPD is a fucking joke. They're a joke. I'm just saying. We all know. I mean, they're laughable. They have their moments, but it's a rarity that they actually do a good police work. Maxie didn't really care for her scenes with Nathan. What are they doing with Nathan? Like, I just want to know. What exactly are they doing? Because Nathan, I mean, he was cool for when he first came on, but do something with him, please. Just explore his whole, like, his background or something. Just do something. Because otherwise, he's just, it's like watching paint dry. Seriously. Do something or get rid of him. I heard Spinelli was coming back. I don't know when, but I heard he was coming back. What else happened? Nina, Franco, Rick. I heard that the new writers were going to try to evolve Franco and Nina more into the canvas. They were going to try to integrate them more into the show, like hang around different characters. I don't see why. I mean, in my opinion, Nina's a pointless character. Franco's an even bigger waste. It's like, just call it a day. Get rid of them. Because I really don't see nothing with Nina and Franco, to be quite honest. I mean, they're better off just by themselves, like doing their own storylines. Because trying to put them into Sonny and Carly and everybody else's orbit, it's not going to work. Like, it's just not going to work because they don't look right being in their business. Like, you know, they just don't seem right. But they got Rick pretty good, though. Basically, they wanted Rick to sign the divorce papers or the annulment papers or whatever. Rick signed it, and then he tried to kick them out the hotel room. Nice try, Rick, but I do remember that was Nina's room first, so you got the skedaddle. So they kicked Rick ass out. Michael and Morgan basically getting into it or whatever. Morgan's a little twit. Michael, I'm going to say this. I am pissed at what the writers are trying to do. I just feel like, what was the fucking point of putting Michael back with the Quartermains? What was the point if he's just going to go right back to being a Corinthos? Once he goes back to Corinthos, and I swear if he changes his name back to Corinthos, he better stay a Corinthos. Because I'm like seriously about to consider him a Corinthos instead of a Quartermain. I know everybody's going to say, well, by blood, he's a Quartermain. Well, he's always going to go back to the Corinthos family because that's where he was raised. But at the same time, Quartermain is his blood. That's his birthright. And I always seen it as Sonny and Carly basically stole him from the Quartermains. That's how I always viewed it. Jason was the real one who fucking raised Michael. But if he go back to being a Corinthos, then hey, I'm over it. I'm going to be so done because like, you sat there and had this whole year-long battle with the Corinthos family, taking Avery away, trying to shut Sonny and Carly out, calling Sonny Sonny instead of calling him dad. Now, all of a sudden, he gets shot. He's back to dad now. I understand he's concerned because this is the guy that, you know, raised him and blah, blah, blah. But I get all of that. But he also shot your fucking father after he promised you he wouldn't touch him. And he broke that promise. And he shot the guy that you were just now getting to know and love. And you're basically letting go of all of that just to go back into his orbit. So now you're back calling him dad and acting like nothing happened. So basically we sat here for a whole year watching pointless storylines. Unless this is RC's attempt of righting a wrong before he stops writing the show. I guess. Whatever. I'm not interested. If he goes back to being a Corinthos, Michael, I will no longer consider him a Quartermain ever again in life. That's just my opinion. Dante scene with Sonny, I actually thoroughly enjoyed that scene. Because Dante, he was speaking the truth. Sonny is selfish. we've all known this. Like, Sonny is so selfish. He's selfish to the core. Like, Sonny is fucking selfish. Sonny always say, oh, I can't give up the mob. I can't this. No, bitch. You choose not to give up the mob. That's why you don't give it up, because you don't want to. It's by choice. He could easily just give that shit up. All you gotta do is give your territories away. Just walk the fuck away. You can easily do that, but you choose not to do that. Because you're selfish. Like, why do you... You have another chance to actually raise your child, a baby, without the violence, without all that bloodshed, and you're choosing to continue to do this life. Sonny has a lot of money. You don't need the mob. You have legitimate businesses that make legitimate money, millions of dollars. Why not focus on your efforts on that? So that way your last child could have a safe life. Your grandson can have a safe life. The rest of your family can continue having a safe life. Instead of walking around with bodyguards all day, worried about a potential threat. Like, seriously, come on now. Sonny's just dumb. He's selfish. And Dante called him out on it. And then as soon as he did, he flatlined. So Patrick had to run in there. I'm curious. I thought Patrick was a neurosurgeon. When did he start taking care of gunshot wounds? I thought he was a specific doctor. They should have another doctor doing this, because Patrick's a neurosurgeon. He don't deal with this kind of shit. He's a brain doctor. But anyway, I guess. A doctor's a doctor. Carly sitting in the chapel. I love the flashbacks of her and Sonny from, like, back in 2005 and stuff, when Laura Wright took over the role, because I used to watch it a lot during that time too, so I kind of missed that time, even though I love Tamara Braun and Sarah Brown, you know, I love them, but when LW took over that role, when she first came on, she was fire. I love Carly. I always loved the Carly character, but now it just seems she's dumb. She rather raise her kids in a mob violent household with blood and shooting and having your kids walk around with bodyguards. She rather, this is why Jax wanted full custody of Jocelyn, because he don't want his daughter raised in this shit. And I don't blame him. Like, who wants their kid raised in this lifestyle? Fearing that you're going to get a phone call one day that someone tried to shoot Sonny Corinthos and your daughter got shot instead, or your daughter got kidnapped because of Sonny. I wouldn't want my kid growing up in that house either. I wouldn't want my child growing up around Sonny Corinthos. And Carly just seems to ignore all of that. That's what makes her an irresponsible ass parent and a dumbass adult. I mean, if you want to put your life at risk, you do that. But you're not going to put my kid's life at risk. So I never blame Jax for that, going after full custody 4 years ago. I don't blame him for that. If I was him, I would reopen that custody case now, like immediately, and get my daughter. So anyway, I think that's everything in this episode today. I have a question, though, because this has been burning on my mind. What police department from these soap operas do you think is the best police department? The GCPD from The Young and the Restless. The PCPD, of course, from General Hospital. The Pine Valley Police Department from All My Children. Or the LP, or the LPD from One Life to Live, or the Salem PD from Days of Our Lives. Which police department you think is better? I'm going to tell you right now which police department I always thought was better. I have to say it. Landview. I always felt Landview PD was better, One Life to Live. I always felt like their police department was on point. Like I said a couple years ago, Bo and John ran the shit out of that police department. Even Bo ran the shit out of it before John, him and Antonio Vega. But anyway, I hope all you have a great day. I'll see you all later. Have a great day.